here's a question for you. How do you guys work with Exelon? I mean, first of all, is Exelon working with Exelon and other facilities across the United
Exelon has their own facilities. Exelon primarily in the Chicago area, the Region 3 area of the NRC, has a number of licensed facilities.
Okay. Well, Exelon's working with OPP. We're not.
Yeah.
Working
and
with
to
well,
answer
but
your,
I mean,
your question
in,
about
in
that.
In terms of bringing it back online, since they're out there trying to upgrade facilities to the safety standards, you want to bring them back online. How do you go through them?
No, we go through OPP. OPP is, still the licensee, the record holder. A holder of the license for the facility. They're the one responsible for the operation.
Who's your point of contact at that facility?
It's the management of the facility. You work through the management. So for Exelon is in a consulting with OPP.
But I'm just trying to get the dynamics of the process. You indicate that the management there. These are the things that we need to do. Okay. And then the resume goes on to Exelon. Is that how the process
works? That's right. So, in any kind of improvements or any type of programmatic reviews, et cetera, they would reach out to Exelon, and they've also reached out to some other third-party consulting firms to get that industry expertise and guidance. And they come back, but it's still their responsibility. It's still OPP's responsibility to do the overall actions.
Now, who is the individual I can't remember the article about? From the NRC who might be speeding up the process, minimizing concerns because
there were some articles in the news.
Who is that individual?
That was my boss, George Pruitt.
Okay.
From the region.
Is he here?
He is not.
Okay.
He has been temporarily replaced by Chris Kennedy. Another one of my bosses who's out in the hall right now. But we're continuing on with our process. The actual thing that's going on right now
is an
internal investigation.
Do they get any bonuses, though, if they bring things on that line?
Another layer of
where do they get this?
Well, the thing you have to recall is the thing that probably kicked this whole thing off is an allegation of
insurgency.
An allegation for insurgency.
Okay.
It's not necessarily a fact.
Okay.
So we're going through the process, this internal investigation, to determine what are the facts.
Every part of 3 Mile Island. The Nuclear Regulatory Commission is
and also,
and
you bring a facility online, they're really
drawn to
that
today.
From
and our job is to make sure the license is safe, how they're operating the plant, how they're doing.
You guys inch them forward,
but that's my job.
Like, what is the actual
process? We run inch every year. We're the guys that show up and
do mechanical inspection
for
every single.
If we see something that's contrary to our
process, within the process.
There's actually guidance that we use for our individual inspectors. You can actually go onto our website right now. We're following the guidance of one of our inspection procedures. The actual number is 95003. You can actually look that up via the NRC website under inspection procedures.
95003.
There's some
and that encompasses all of the things that we're going to be able to look at. It encompasses programs, it encompasses specific looks at systems, it encompasses safety culture, so that is it's rather extensive.
Okay. And so the disparity is you guys aren't going to be rushed. You're going to make sure that it's all absolutely compliant. And so, in saying that, how could anybody, like you say, how can anybody do this in time?
That's what I'm saying. We're not
We're
NRC
not.
Has not predicted.
So that's. But are they remiss for giving us the timeline of September?
We need to make sure that we're.
You know, that's something that you're going to have to
discuss.
I can't fault them.
It's this.
The business, I would have said it was something.
Correct. So we have issued
what orders, you know, from the
actual state of this. We're not going to.
We should specify on our side. Where they might be, whether or not it might be a conference.
So
it's going to be by what our activity is.
So the inspection process, you outline all the things that they were here to do. And so did they perform one or two or three of those, and they have you come back out and inspect it, say, are we compliant, and then they move to the next one?
I'm presently in the process of setting up something similar to that. They would come out with, I'll call it, for lack of a better term, modules or packages of things that they've accomplished, and they will notify us. They'll say, we're ready for you to inspect this area or these areas or these types of activities. We'll have them have a team come and inspect those type of things. We'll write about that in our quarterly inspection reports and disposition. And you know how that went, whether that is a closed aspect or whether we have some additional things we need to look at.
If you had to move on to the next area. If you had to put a number on the number of items that have to be checked to bring it back online, quantitatively put a number on it, because they're in 95003. How many would you say there are?
We're in the process of working on a restart check. And now restart checklist on the specific aspects of what the licensing is going to happen. They're rather high level. There's going to be some sub-tiering to that, some aspects of that. But we're talking about overall programs or specific areas somewhere on the order of a dozen to 20 projects. That's a high level type of thing. When you get down to very, very specific aspects, there could be hundreds of things that we take a look at.
But I guess the thing that's kind of a quandary for me is just imagining how they could go from such a high ranking to such a low ranking, or move down in the categories as a result of, I guess, was it the fire? Was it something in 2008? Or was it just the culmination?
It's a culmination. It's actually a culmination. What we would anticipate and what we hope we see from licensees throughout the country is, as you would have progressed into column two or into column three, that the licensee would have taken action to turn himself. The licensee would have taken that corrective action to get themselves back to column one. We did not see that here. So again, in our graded approach, we're going to give even more emphasis, even more oversight as you continue to walk through this. So it was a culmination of the findings, and the licensee did not necessarily turn himself back to that column one report.
So in 2008 was the first time, that was the first citation of the safety issues.
That was in, I'll call it in recent history. They've had some significant inspection findings throughout their operations. They've been operating since the 70s. They have some, but the oversight process that we're carrying out, we had the oversight process begin roughly in 2000. Since 2000, they have been, they have progressed twice out into this column three, column four type of inspection thing. And that all basically started in 2000. So recent performance, I will call, from 2008, they have had this decline. We have had this graded or increased inspection oversight.
So the manual actually says that if one of the licensees has two declines and hasn't made an improvement, we're going to move them to the next category. Is it that kind of a thing?
It's basically that kind of consideration. We look for, It's a program that has what I would call a risk and reward associated with it. If a licensee performs very well, and we do not see any kind of, you know, problems with what they're doing, they remain in column one, and they receive the base inspection efforts, the base oversight efforts. As, you know, any kind of performance would decline, you're going to get increased oversight, increased oversight.
Now, I mean, are you missed by the lack of progress or the decline? I mean, to you,
personally, yes. You know, I don't have a, you know, I'm a regulator. That's my job.
You're a regulator.
You know, my job is to oversee the facility. The facility is in the situation that they're in. Don't take any.
But I mean, if you went home to your wife and say, "Guy, I can't believe it. These guys." I mean, what would you tell her? Say, I know you have a political stand, but I mean, you have more than anybody, I see, a better sense of what is going on there.
I would leave it at the expectation that they would have caught themselves differently. The fact that they're in this.
Because you sent them letters, you sent them notifications.
Yes, and we've been speaking with them over the past couple years. I've actually had the oversight of the branch for this facility since 2007. We have been sending them very strong messages.
To me, I can't imagine. I mean, I sell houses. So, you know, when you
and that's what we're
inspection notice, you got to do this. I mean, you're right on. And on this instance, they get letters from you. They could lose their license. And that's eventually, that's what happens. So I guess what I'm saying is, do you have any explanation? I know you don't want to get into it. Do you have any explanation as to why? Was it miscommunication in the management or why they didn't react to these warnings?
I think that's a little bit more internal to OPPD, and I think they're going to have to come up with those kind of, you know, soul searching or self-assessment type of answers as to why within their organization they didn't come to this realization a little bit sooner. But, you know, that is something that they're going to have to resolve. That's something, if they are going to progress, get to a situation where they restart the facility, get to a situation where they could move back to column one, they're going to have to make some kind of changes.
Okay.
And in making those kind of changes, there's going to have to be an assessment process internally and say, you know, how did we miss the mark? How did we not take this into consideration?
They're going to have to sit provide you with that.
Right.
Okay, so I just want to make sure I have this. Column one, column two, column three, column four.
There's a five.
There is.
There is also a manual chapter 0351 and an 0351. Now, the difference between the 0351 and the 0350 is long-term shutdown facilities with performance issues and ones that do not have performance issues. So a 351 plan has to be something like a tornado or a hurricane.
Fukushima.
Yes, that it wasn't the cause of the operator. It was some external.
0050 is the operator.
Yes.
And that's a long-term shutdown.
That's correct.
And currently, Fort Calhoun's in four.
They were in four. We put them in the 0350 is a different column.
So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 0050 is operational problems.
Operational problems mean long-term shutdown.
Okay. That's pretty telling. And there's only one other one in the country that's in that category?
There is no other plant that's in that category. There's one other plant that's in all four. That's Brown's Ferry.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Thank you.